to sanction or not to sanction North Korea. Prosanction people are saying the latest round of U.S. measures against the North may indeed bring enough pressure on Kim Jong-un to agree to talks about giving up his nuclear program and missiles. The anti-sanctionists say such pressure never works, and may tempt Kim instead to test still more missiles, just to prove what a great and independent leader he is. We're never going to hear the end of this debate. Nor will we ever get any definitive answers. If Kim does order another test of a long-range missile capable of carrying a warhead to the U.S., who will know for sure if sanctions or the absence of them would have made a difference? And if he doesn't test another long-range missile, can anyone tell if he put off the idea just because the sanctions were really hurting? It's all a guessing game, in which President Donald Trump's decision to restore North Korea to the U.S. State Department's list of sponsors of terror adds colorful quotes to the argument. If nothing else, it helps Trump score rhetorical or propaganda points. Proponents of a strong U.S. policy think he has done what's needed to bring Kim to his senses and bow to the demands of just about every leader on Earth. If Kim dies, don't ask CIA if he fires a missile, read manga after briefly making headlines in the U.S. However, these gestures do not appear really to have advanced the story. Certainly, a few more Chinese companies may be constrained from doing business with North Korea, and certainly North Korean leaders do not like the terror label now any more than they did in 2008, when then U.S. President George W. Bush ordered the removal of the North from the list. Bush was persuaded by Condoleezza Rice, then Secretary of State, that removing the North from the list would provide Pyongyang with enough face to abide by agreements hammered out by U.S. delegation head Christopher Hill in six-party talks, to give up its nuclear program on a Kerry-devised timetable. Hill also got the U.S. Treasury Department to remove constraints that had forced Banco Delta Asia in Macau to freeze millions of dollars in North Korean accounts. Former U.S. and Japanese nuclear negotiators warn that Kim Jong-un deserves no carrots. Anyone could have seen that Hill, looking for a place in history as the diplomat who got the North to give up nuclear ambitions, was more or less out of his mind. What made him imagine that then-leader Kim Jong-il, the father of Kim Jong-un, would ever abide by such a deal had he not totally ignored the 1991 North-South Agreement on denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula and then violated the 1994 Geneva Framework Agreement by engaging in a program for fabricating warheads with highly enriched uranium, after making a great show of shutting down the North's plutonium reactor? Donald Trump puts North Korea back on terror blacklist. Hill these days is saying North Korean negotiators lied to him, broke their promises and were otherwise quite deceptive. He has been saying he always thought the North would go back on the terror list as soon as it became clear they were breaking their promises. In the meantime, Banco Delta Asia had gone on serving as a conduit for distributing counterfeit North Korean $100 bills, while North Korea's Office 39 deposited profits from sales of weapons, narcotics, even cigarettes, with phony foreign labels. Secrets of Office 39. Kim gets Russian fuel via Singapore dealers, says defector who fled China, having said North Korea should have remained on the terror list along with Syria, Iran and Sudan. Where does Trump go from here? As Trump, having described his recent Asia trip as historic, ready to move beyond histrionics, what if Kim Jong-un does order another long-range missile test? North Korea hits back at Trump for warmonger Asia tour. It's often said that Trump is so tough that he is capable of some wild act, a preemptive strike that might precipitate counterattacks on South Korea's populated industrial regions. It's the fear of such a reaction from the North that inhibits President Moon Jae-in from going along with U.S. hints of a military option if diplomacy fails. Many Americans, like Moon, also fear that the North might unleash a devastating response. Nobody wants to take that chance. It would probably be extremely risky to predict the next act in the great Korean drama. We have so often been surprised. Let's hope intensified pressure does have a certain effect. Donald Kirk is the author of three books and numerous articles on Korea.